I don't know why, but I freak out every single time I hold the drone for takeoff. And I also close my eyes as if that is going to somehow help the situation.
I'm Jess, and this is Charles. In the middle of a global pandemic, we decided to trade in land life for something a bit more fluid. Enter Leviosa and the two cutest deckhands you'll ever meet. We spent the first year getting our sea legs, and now we're ready for a new set of adventures. Leviosa is currently in Fort Pierce, Florida, our final U.S. port before we make our way to the Bahamas in a couple of weeks. But today, we're going behind the scenes to answer one of our most frequently asked questions.
We figured we'd put out a video a little early this week and go through what we use to make our videos. I think it's important to understand that we started with a lot of the gear that we have. And the reason for that is because Jess would tell you that I am a serial hobby collector. And most of the time, those hobbies take the form of something creative because I really wish I was more creative than I actually am. So I've taken up piano, I've taken up drawing. A while back, I took up photography, and that was the one that kind of stuck. And by no means an expert, but we bought the boat and we had a lot of gear just for my photography hobby. So what we quickly learned is that while taking photos and making videos are mechanically the same, the art of making them is much, much different. And so most of what we bought since we started making videos is actually the little things, the accessories that really help you on the video production, because ultimately what we found is that the devil is in the details. Notice that I said serial collector of hobbies. We are by no means professionals here. I'm going to give you what I think is the most important things for our production. If you're looking for professional advice, Peter McKinnon does this all the time. There's a ton of really good photographers, videographers out there on YouTube that go through the gears that they use. This is just the gear that we use, and we're learning every day. So with that, let's get into it. The way that we think about making our videos is really in two phases. The first one is what you hear when you're watching a video. And the second one is what you see. So we're making a video. Why do we start with audio? Well, the reason for that is something called cognitive dissonance. And what that means is it's actually stressful for your brain to process audio that is not clear. It's easier for your brain to process blurry or blown out or too dark video than it is to process bad audio. And so we always start with, is the audio going to be clear and concise and audible, as it were? So when you're a sailing channel, the number one thing you have to think about when you're dealing with audio is wind. If you don't protect your mic from the wind, then you're just going to hear a whole bunch of static once it actually gets onto the video. So number one, all of our mics have what they call dead cats, furry cats, whatever you want to call them. And really all it does is it protects the actual microphone receiver from the wind. So you'll see we've got a number of them. They all fit different mics. But if we actually get into the mics themselves, this is the first one that we picked up. It's $20 or $25 on Amazon. It's a TacStar. We'll put a link to everything in the description below. But it works surprisingly well for being $20 or $25. You can see it's very elongated. So it's a shotgun mic, which means it picks up sound directionally. It won't pick up sound on the sides or behind it, which is really important when you're vlogging. The biggest drawback of this particular mic is that you have to remember to turn it on and turn it off. Not a big deal, but you know, it's a little bit of a pain. We've definitely shot video where we thought the mic was on and it wasn't, which pretty much ruins the video. The next mic that we bought is actually the one that's on the camera right now. It is our primary go-to mic for every vlog that we record. It sits on our primary camera almost 99% of the time or 100% of the time. And it is a Rode, I don't remember what it's called. It's a Rode microphone. Again, we'll put all the links in the description below. It's relatively inexpensive as far as mics go, and it works phenomenally well. It gets its power from the camera itself, so you don't have to worry about changing batteries or having your batteries die, and you don't have to worry about turning it on or off. It's just on when the camera's on. So the next microphone that we use is this little guy right here. And this one, if you notice the lightning connector, plugs into the iPhone. We try not to shoot much on the iPhone, especially when we need audio, but sometimes that's the camera you have, right? It's always nice to have the external mic to give you just that little bit more clear and concise audio. And obviously you can see it's very small. It just comes with us wherever we go. And so if we are shooting on the iPhone, we just pop it on there. And then the last one here is we recently upgraded our GoPro. GoPro is notorious for having bad audio, and the GoPro 9 and 10 have what they call the media connector, or the media mod, I think, which comes with an external mic on it, but it also comes with the ability to add an actual external mic so we can put our primary vlogging mic onto our GoPro. So having said all that, that's what is helping us so far, right? We still have a ways to go. You still have to think about the direction the wind is coming from. If it's coming straight across the camera, you're still gonna get some wind noise in there. And there's a couple things that we've talked about purchasing that we haven't yet. Like off-camera mics is probably the next iteration in our audio journey. Rode makes an interesting off-camera mic, or you can do boom mics and some other things like that. Ultimately, most of the time we're shooting relatively close up, so the on-camera mic works very well. But there have been a couple times where we wanted to shoot a longer shot where the off-camera mic would have come in handy. So that's how we think about audio. So let's move on to what you see. All of this might look intimidating because, to be honest, there's a lot of gear here. But keep in mind, we owned almost all of this before we even started, including the camera that we're shooting on right now that you don't see. So let's start with what we had. This is a Nikon D7100. It's the first real kind of big camera that I had. And I probably used this for my photography for a couple of years before I upgraded to the D750 that we're shooting on right now. Both of those are prosumer level cameras. They're a couple of years old at this point, and they are workhorse photography cameras. But again, ultimately, all of that was purchased prior to making a single video for my photography hobby, whatever you want to call it, right? This little Sony camera is also a camera that we owned. This is what we actually took all of our honeymoon photos on, and was the camera that made me want to get a DSLR. I vividly remember when we were on our honeymoon, looking at photos, taking them, seeing them, how they came out in this camera, and realizing that I could do better with a better camera. This kind of went into the drawer for a while until we started making videos. And this little Sony is actually pretty good as a video camera. It doesn't do external audio, so it's really only used for B-roll, but we do actually use it a decent amount to get some B-roll shots. This is our workhorse camera for creating videos, and this is the one camera that we bought specifically for the purpose of making videos. It is a Nikon Z50, and the reason that we like it is because it's so small and so compact. And the number one thing that you always learn about photography or making videos is that the best camera is the one that is in your hand. If you don't have your camera, you're not shooting. And the D750 and the D7100 were so big and bulky, especially with those lenses, that we didn't bring them unless we knew we were going out to shoot, right? And most of what you want to shoot happens in the moment. And so if you don't have your camera, you're not shooting. We bought this with the express purpose of making videos. It's a mirrorless camera. This is a very small lens that goes very, very compact. It fits in a bag very easily. And then if you're vlogging, you don't have a tripod or someone to hold the camera for you, the screen also flips down so you can hold it like that and see yourself. Again, this is the one camera that we bought with the express purpose of vlogging, and it has done really, really well for us. That's how you get the majority of your story, your main story, your A-roll, whatever you're calling it. We're not industry professionals, but we like to use jargon. We're sailors, right? Every sailor likes jargon. So here we go. After you have your main story, the next thing that you need to think about is the details, right? And to me, every time I watch another channel, the details are the interesting parts. The people that are able to tell a story without talking are the ones, to me, that are the most interesting. And we're not there yet. I will be the first to tell you that we're not there yet, but we're trying. Obviously, we get a lot of B-roll with the main cameras, but the really interesting shots come from what I'll call specialized cameras, right? So I have a Mavic 2 Pro. Again, I had this before we started making videos, because I like gadgets, but this is our workhorse drone. The Mavic 3 actually just came out. I have no desire to get it because I love this guy. It does everything that we need it to do, and I'm not the world's best drone pilot, but I'm getting there, and this guy does everything that we need. If you've seen one of our other videos, you know that we didn't have a controller for the Mavic for a little while, and the controllers were on back order, and so we picked up a Mini, and this is Jess's drone, and she loves flying it, and she is also not the world's best drone pilot, but she's also getting better. Just like the Z50, the Mini goes with us pretty much everywhere, so we always have the drone available if we need it. Taking the video from the sky to underwater, we've got new GoPros, right? This is a GoPro 6, I believe. Again, had this just for fun before we really started making videos for YouTube. it's done really, really well for us. But recently we did upgrade to a Hero 10. And the main reason we upgraded to the Hero 10 I talked about earlier is because it gives us external audio options. That means that we can use it in a much wider array of situations. And we can even use it and have used it in lieu of the Z50 when we're in a pinch. The other nice thing about the GoPros and the drones is that they have built-in stabilization, which we'll get into in a little bit. And then finally, obviously we have our phones. Always have the phone in the pocket, and so in a pinch, if it's the only thing we have, we'll take some video on a phone. And if the phone is all you have, that's perfectly fine. We shot entire videos exclusively on our phone and they've turned out fine. Other people have shot entire videos on their phone and they've turned out amazing. So you can do a lot with your phone. And so if that's all you have, great, that's what you should use. Now that we actually have video on a camera, I think it's important to talk about light. So this is one of the things that translated from photography to videography very well. You always have to be cognizant of where the light is coming from, as far as direction goes, as far as brightness goes. The camera sees light in a much different way than your eye does. Most notably, the range that your camera has is much smaller. I'm not gonna go into too many details, but just understand that the way the camera sees the light is different than the way that your eye sees the light. So you have to train yourself a little bit to understand. You probably need to help your camera with specific lighting situations. And so everything you see on the table right now is designed to do that. We're shooting in bright sunlight a lot. And so what we're trying to do is make the light darker. The easiest way to accomplish that is with filters. If you take one thing from this video, take this. This is a neutral density filter, which basically acts like sunglasses for your camera. But the really nice part about this one is that it has variable intensity. So you can go from very light tinted sunglasses to very dark tinted sunglasses without having to change your filter. And that's been the best thing for us. We always shoot in bright daylight, and this filter really helps the camera work with that bright daylight. This one fits our Z50. It is $45 on Amazon. If there's one thing that you can buy that will really help you with videos, it's the neutral density filter. This has also been a game changer for Jess. She's not the most technically savvy with the camera and all of the different settings that are available. So this lets her dial in the proper exposure just by rotating the filter. And that's been a really, really big game changer for her and her ability to get quality video footage. The other side of the coin of making things darker is that sometimes you want to make them brighter, right? And so we have a couple of lights that we use to do that. This is just a Loom Cube. They're actually mostly advertised for Zoom conferences and things like that right now, but it does a really good job. You know, you can do some interesting things that, to be honest, we don't really do with it. We just use it to fill shadows and things like that. And then this is a very, very bright LED light that helps us overpower the sun when we need to. Obviously, we can't actually overpower the sun, but if we're shooting in bright, bright, bright daylight and the ND filter is only doing so much, we'll bust out this light to help fill the shadows and make it so we don't have like really, really high contrast dark shadows on our face, which are rarely flattering and not what you're going for when you're making a video. And sometimes there is no technical answer. You just have to build yourself a fort to block out the light. The last piece here is just like the main cameras have filters and ways to alter the light, so do the drones and the GoPros, right? So these filters are ND filters for the Mavic, exact same concept. Unfortunately, they're not variable, so you have to figure out which one you need for any given situation, but it really helps cut down on that bright sunlight. The last filter we have here are our red light filters for our Hero 10. And I'm not going to go into all the science behind it, but the important thing to understand is that the further you go underwater, the more red light you lose. And so by adding these filters onto the GoPro, when you go underwater, you get that red light back. And there's different colors for different depths, but that's the general idea. And if you ever wanted to learn more about light or how your eye perceives it or how the camera perceives it, I'll put a link in the description below, but there's a book that is the holy grail of understanding light and color and how they all play together, especially when you're thinking about creating a video. The last thing I wanted to talk about is stabilization. And unless you're trying to make the Blair Witch or a Jason Bourne fight scene, you generally want smooth footage. We might be getting seasick during our videos, but we don't want you to get seasick during our videos. And so we accomplish that in a number of ways. The first and easiest way is to hold the camera steady. I'm not gonna talk too much about that, but it goes a long way. So the second thing you can do is put your camera on a tripod. And we have a primary tripod that I've owned forever. It's what we're shooting on right now. And it really does help, right? Obviously, a tripod keeps things stable. You don't have to worry about it. Your arm doesn't go numb holding up the camera. And a whole slew of benefits. So we have a number of different tripods depending on the situation. This guy works great for iPhones and also when you just need a low shot. This is another lightweight tripod that you can carry around wherever you want to go. Gorilla pods are cool because you can wrap them around posts and do whatever you want to do with them. You kind of get some interesting shots. It's a little bit less of a tripod and kind of a clamp. The primary drawback of a tripod is obviously that the camera remains 100% stationary. And that's perfectly fine in a lot of different situations, like what we're doing right now. Now, if you want the camera to be in motion and have more stable footage than you can do on your own, that's where a gimbal comes into play. And we've got two. This is a DJI OM4 for the iPhone. We get a lot of our B-roll using the iPhone and using this gimbal. It helps keep it nice and smooth. And this guy is a June Crane M2. And the camera that fits this the best is the Sony, but it is also just barely big enough for the Z50. And everything you see over here is for the GoPros. The action camera industry, regardless of the brand, they all have a ton of different mounts because you're supposed to be using them in a ton of different situations, right? So this is a floating handle, this is a suction cup, this is a mini tripod, this is a mount that you use to mount around a pole, so on and so forth. And ultimately what you use those for is whatever the situation dictates is you can have a way to mount the camera in a way that is safe and hopefully you won't lose. So that's all the gear that we use to create our videos. And sure, there's a wish list like off-camera microphones, a full-frame mirrorless camera, a gimbal that the Z50 will fit. But ultimately what it boils down to is that you can have all of the perfectly shot footage and perfect audio that you want. The goal is to tell a compelling story. We get inspired by some of the great channels out there, like The Winds, Peter McKinnon, Nate and Kara. The reason that they're so great has nothing to do with the gear that they have, although they all have gear episodes just like this one. It is because they tell a very, very interesting and compelling story. So if there's someone in your life who's interested in making videos and you think any of this was helpful, all of our favorite gear is listed below. It's also on our website. And if you have any questions at all about us, just ask.
Hey guys, I know I've been MIA this episode because I have been behind the scenes today, but I wanted to quickly jump on and say happy Thanksgiving to everyone who celebrates it.
And if you don't, happy Thursday, and we'll see you next week.